back to our what's it called, our Flappy Bird series. In today's episode, we are working on episode 4, I think. Well, episode 3, but yeah, so episode 3. In the previous episode, we worked on the adding in the platform and adding in some physics to our player, and then we also got the bird, which is our player, to start jumping up. Was it jumping or like flying? Whenever you click the mouse button, the left mouse button. So let's jump into Unity and see what we want. Let's just have a recap on that. So we'll play the game quick, and we will see that if we, well, obviously the because our player has got physics on it now, it also has gravity. Gravity scale of 1. So whenever we click on our screen somewhere, we add some force to our bird, and then it goes flying up. And then when you let go, it obviously drops down to the floor. So that's good. So in today's episode, we're just going to work on the. We're going to start working on the obstacles, which is the pipes, and we are going to set up a prefab of those so that we can keep swinging in them at different intervals, and well, the same interval, but at different like heights. And then we are also going to work on a spawner that will allow us to spawn these pipes every so often. So let's go ahead and do that. So the first thing on the list is add the two pipes into the scene and then add a collider onto them. So we'll go ahead and tick those off. And then actually we'll go ahead and do the next one as well. So we'll create an empty object first as a parent. So if we create an empty object in our hierarchy and we call this, what are we going to call it? What did I write here? Make it obstacle pipes. Obstacle pipe. So we'll say or should I name it that? Yeah, so obstacle pipes like that. And then what we want to do is we want to go and find our pipe somewhere. This one, I think it is, pipe down. Well, let's zoom out quick and move them off the screen. So pipe down and pipe up. So we want these two, so we're going to go, first of all, let's go ahead and reset the position of all of these. So, like that, and then we can, for the pipe down, we can move it down a little bit, so let's go and shift that down, or rather up, and then for our pipe up, let's go and shift that down a little bit. So that's fine. And then what we want to do is we want to drag these two, pipe up and pipe down, into our game. A new game object that we created, which is called the obstacle pipe, so it becomes a child object. So now we can now move this to the left a bit, and now whenever we move our obstacle pipes, because the two pipes are now a child of it, it actually moves the whole thing. So we're going to create a prefab out of this whole game object. So let's go ahead in our assets, create a new folder. Call this prefabs like that, and then we will drag this this game object, which is called the obstacle pipes, into our prefabs folder, and that's going to create a prefab for us. You can see it's now turned blue, so we can actually reuse this and just keep dragging as many as we want into it, but we're not going to do that. We are going to use some code to spawn a bunch of different one every few seconds, I think it is. So let's go see what is next on the list. So we could actually, now that we've created that, let's go ahead and delete that. We'll leave it there for now and see what happens later. So now let's go see, create a new obstacle script and add it onto the game object that we call, that we created. So let's go and do that. So just to tidy things up, let's go ahead and create a new scripts folder. So let's call this scripts. Like that. And then we'll drag in our player script into our scripts folder, and then in here we'll create another C sharp script, sorry, and we will call this what do we call it, obstacles, I think. Create a new obstacle script, so we'll call it obstacle. Why am I not typing? So new behavior, obstacle. And then if we click on our prefab, well, let's go into our prefab here. And we'll, first of all, we'll delete this. And then we'll open up our prefab by double clicking on it. And then we can simply, on our parent object, we can go ahead and add in that obstacle script. And we can't find it, so we'll drag it onto there, just like that. Good script class cannot be found. Okay, so let's go and open this up and see. New behavior script. So we need to change this to obstacle like that, save that, and then now we should be able to add it onto our parent object. So if we click when this is finished, if we click on the parent object of our pipes, go to add component and now type in obstacle, we can see there's our script. So we'll add that onto it. And now let's jump back to Notion and see what's next. And create a new game object to act like a obstacle spawner. So let's go and do that. So this is going to be this first one, let's go back to our game. And here let's just drag in one for now, just for like a reference. So now we want to create a new game object. And we're going to use this as like a reference for wherever we want to, or the same place we want to spawn another set of pipes into the game. So we'll call this, what are we calling it? What do I type here? Named obstacle spawner. So we'll go and change the name of it from game object to obstacle. Spawner. We'll copy that and save that. And just because I didn't really name this properly, we'll paste that in there. And then we will delete that and just drag in a new one with a new name. So that's fine. And then we'll update this one as well. Obstacle. And then because I changed that, we need to change the name over here as well. So we'll correct all of those. Silly mistake. So let's go ahead and see. So now what's next? So we've created a obstacle spawner. And let's go ahead and position this somewhere. So we want this, well, let's go ahead and reset it first. And then we'll just drag it out somewhere to around here maybe. And then the next thing we want to do is reset the transform and drag it to the right of the screen, which we've already done. So now let's create a new spawner script to spawn all the pipes. So I think we're going to add this onto there, assign the new script to the obstacle. So let's go and do that. So if we click on the obstacle spawner, we can actually just recreate the, or create a new script on it already. So we want to name the spawner like that, and we'll create a new script called spawner. So that now creates a new script, so we'll drag that into our scripts folder if it lets us. So when this finishes, so let's try it again, drag that into there just to keep our project tidy. So cool, so let us have a look and see what's next. So now we need to write some code in our spawner so that whenever we like play the game, it spawns some new pipes every so on. So let's see, what do we need to do? So if we open our spawner script wherever we did that, so let's go and open this up. And we're not really going to be using the start method, so we'll go ahead and delete that. And in here, we're going to need some variables, three to be exact. So we're going to need a queue time. So let's go ahead and say public, public float. I'll name this queue time. Queue time. We'll set that to 1.5, I think, for now. And then 1.5f to be exact, because it's a float and it's got a decimal. And the next one we'll say private. We'll create a float as well, and this one's going to be time. So this is going to be the time that's elapsed between each spawn. And the next one is we're going to need a reference to the game object that we're going to keep spawning, which in this case is the set of pipes. This is going to be a game object, and we'll call this obstacle. Just like that. And then we'll actually need another one because we want to change the height of where they get spawned so that it's not just like a simple straight line. So here we'll go public float, and we'll call this height. And then in our update method, we want to say if the time is greater than the queue time, then we want to go ahead and spawn another set of pipes. So let's go and say game object object, or rather game object is equal to instantiate, and here we want to instantiate the obstacle that we, well, this obstacle, so let's just copy that because I messed that up. So copy obstacle and pop it in there, and then we want to give it the position. So here let's go and say game object dot transform dot position is equal to the transform dot position plus a new vector 3, and in here we want to give it a random value on the y-axis so that it doesn't always show you here. So instead of having, where is our prefab, so let's drag another one just so I can show you. So instead of having them all spawn in a straight line like this, we want to make it random, so like one up there, one there, and then maybe one down here, and then like another one over like here, maybe like that. So it's all different and you have to try and work your way through all of them. So we'll go and set a random value for that. So here we want to say random dot range, and we want to give it a a minimum and a maximum value. So here let's say we're going to take our height and we're going to make it a negative height. So that's going to be our minimum value, and then we're going to take the same height and keep that positive, and that's going to just set our maximum value. And then for our z-axis, we're just going to set that to 0. And then the next thing we want to do is we want to set our time to equal to 0. And then we want to destroy the game object that we just created after, let's say, about 10 seconds, I think. Just so that whenever we spawn a new one, after 10 seconds, in other words, at that point, it's going to be off the screen. So we don't really want it in our scene. So we'll go ahead and destroy it. And then over here, let's go ahead and set time is equal to plus equals time dot delta time. This needs to be, where is it? So capital, there we go, time dot delta time. So that's just to keep track of the actual time so that we know when to spawn in some new obstacle pipes. So we'll go ahead and play this and see where we're at. So if we save that, so for on our obstacle spawner, we're going to have to add in our prefab. We'll drag it in, so we'll drag in our prefab into there, and we'll set our height at 5 for now, just to see what that's like. So let's go ahead and play this and see what happens. So let's see if anything happens. So let's see. So you can see now everything is being spawned, and I think they're all at different heights, so you can see, yeah, so you can see that they're all being spawned. So I'm just gonna move them like this. So there's one, there's another one, they're all getting spawned at different heights, so that's good. So we'll go ahead and stop this. So we could probably delete that, and let's just make sure that they keep spawning. So while that loads, let me just check what's next on the list. Next. Okay, cool. Okay, perfect. So, okay, so they are still spawning, but they're spawning off screen. Okay, great. So, let us see. Okay, so let's go back to our Notion and see. So, assign a new script onto the obstacle spawner game object, which we did, and we created a new pipes prefab. So, we'll save that. And then we will have a look and see. So let's play this quick again just to recheck. So I probably need to change the value, because I think 5 is a bit too much. So let's change that to, let's say, about 2 just for now. So let's play that. And then what we also want to do is, first of all, let's go into our other script, the obstacle. I don't think we opened that one, so let's open that up. And we need to add some code in here so that we can actually see these moving. So let's go and create a public. We'll call this, well, it needs to be a float, and we'll call this speed. And then in our update, we need to add some speed onto these obstacles so that they don't spawn in one location. Well, they spawn in the same location, but they move over time so you can see them. So here, let's say transform.position plus equal, which means add this onto every whenever the update method is called, which is every frame. So let's go and say vector 3.left times the speed, so times speed like that, and then we want to go and times it by time dot delta time, just like that. So now that should make the obstacles move from the right side of the screen towards the other end on the left side, obviously. So let us go and play this and see if it works. So let's play the game. We might have to change the height of the random range just so that we can see what's happening. So let's see. Okay, so that's, did we save that? We saved that. Have we added the obstacle spawner onto it? So let's see. Obstacle spawner, what's happening here? So let's see. Have we missed out a step? Let's see. We don't have the obstacle spawn, so this needs to be, let's see, first of all on here, obstacle, well, yeah, so let's add a speed onto here, and we'll change this in the game so we can set it at a value that we want. So let's say about 5 maybe, so there, that's a bit too fast, we'll go and change that to 2 maybe, maybe even 1. Okay, so that's 1, looks maybe 1.5 maybe. Nah, we'll keep it at 1 for now. But we also need to change some things. So we need to change 1, well, we'll add that at 1 for now, and we'll go ahead and play the game. So let's just see, now that we've got the pipes moving, we can see that when they do spawn, they spawn, or some of them are spawning at the wrong different heights. So we need to go and fix that, but I think we'll do that in the next episode, because this one is at almost 20 minutes. So we'll just save our project quick. So we'll save that, and we'll save that, and then we'll go ahead and end this video. So let's have a recap quick. So what we did today was we added the obstacles and we made them move from right of the screen to the left. So in the next video, we'll probably work on getting them to spawn in like the right range, so that you don't get one spawning at the bottom of the screen and one spawning all the way at the top of the screen. And then we'll also go ahead and work on start making the floor actually scroll with the game, so it doesn't look like it's stationary. So that's what we're going to be doing in the next episode. So if you're interested in watching that and learning more, please go ahead and like the video and also subscribe so you know when that video comes out. But for now, I think that's it for this episode. So thank you so much for watching again, and I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye.